Hey there, friends. Thanks for checking in. A video recently surfaced about a guy that was trying to kill a lady, but the gun malfunctioned. Either that or the thumb safety was engaged and this guy was too stupid to figure it out. But that is what happened. Security camera footage captured the video of this guy trying to shoot and kill a lady in broad daylight. Now, this speaks volumes to all the people that say, well, you know, they just want to steal some stuff so they can feed their family. That's a bunch of garbage. This could have been a drug deal gone bad. It could have been a relationship gone wrong. It could have been a hit. It could have been a multitude of things. The fact is, this guy tried to kill this woman and failed. All right, failed in a good way, thankfully, because she still can live. But something seriously went wrong with his plan. Now, this was most likely a stolen gun. It clearly was not function tested, all right? He could have just stole this gun and decided he was gonna kill this. It could have been a random person for all we know, but the situation did not work out the way he had hoped, and we are thankful for that. He had a black shirt covering his identity. It is my belief that he's going to get caught because there's another shot of his face as he was running away. It also speaks to the cowardice of the people who want to, you know, shoot and kill somebody. It didn't work out. He turned around and ran away. You know, are these real tough people? No, they're not. And it also reinforces that we're not sure what people are capable of. We have no idea what people are capable of. Therefore, we have to constantly have our guard up and be ready to defend ourselves. It also speaks to the importance of making sure that our gun is mechanically sound. Now, it's pretty pathetic that we have to use an example like this to prepare ourselves, but nonetheless, that gun didn't work. Now, I have to believe that it was incompetence of the potential shooter, all right? User error. It could have been a mechanical failure. It could have been an ammo thing. It could have been many different things. But when was the last time you took your carry gun out, cleaned out the holster, took it apart, made sure it was properly looped, changed out the ammo? You know, these are the types of things we need to think about. It also reminds me of a story that a friend of mine who's a cop told me. In Michigan, they qualify once a year for their firearm, shall I say, precision, okay? Basically, they shoot a silhouette-sized target and they have to hit that from about 15 yards 8 out of 10 times, okay? So it's minimal of what they need to accomplish. So every time I hear somebody say, well, you know, you don't need to do anything, just call the cops. They know what they're doing. In many cases, they have no idea what they're doing. And this is evidence of that. Now, this officer went to qualify, never touched his gun since it was issued. It was an issued duty issued Glock 22, 40 Smith & Wesson. Never did anything to it, never had to use his gun. He pulls it out to qualify and click. It was filled with grime, lint, dirt, you know, most likely over-lubed and gummed up there. His gun was unfunctioning. Now, that could have been the very tool he needed to save his life or somebody else's in a crime. Thankfully, it didn't work out that way, but his gun was useless, all because he didn't take proper care of it. So whether it's a idiot who tries to kill a lady and the gun doesn't work right, or he doesn't work right, or his mind's too stupid to figure it out, or a cop who never took care of his firearm, we need to take a moment and evaluate our own self and say, you know what, I haven't changed out my ammo in a while, you know? How's that magazine spring doing? Did I clean out my holster? Did I disassemble my gun and lube it in the proper areas and make sure everything's functioning? Have I shot it recently and make sure that I am competent enough? If I have to make a 15-yard shot that's a rather tight shot, can I do it? You know, we have to know our own capabilities, and we could take a lesson like this, like some idiot who tried to kill a lady and was unsuccessful in doing so, and use it for our own increased competence. It will only make us more prepared. If you like videos like this, please subscribe and share. I always appreciate the thumbs up button. Thanks for watching, and you guys be safe.